Hi y'all, this is So Blessed. Welcome to The Blessed Place. How y'all doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome all my new blessed ones. And welcome all my veteran blessed ones. I love you all. I just wanted to come by and say hi and just shout out a few people. Today is World Kindness Day. And I just want to encourage you to be kind. Be kind, y'all. I don't have to tell y'all what kind of world we're living in. I do not have to tell y'all. Just turn on your news, read social media. Open up a social media page and just see the nastiness that some people can leave under your comments and your videos. Not so much in The Blessed Place, but it happens very rarely. But I read it under other people's page. Y'all, just so much. I mean, catastrophic loss. I'm just not going to go into it because I don't want to make this video just down and depressive, because this video is all about uplifting you all to be kind. We can use a lot more kindness in our lives. Just small gestures. I was just listening to the radio, and they were announcing that it's World Kindness Day, and they asked, you know, what have you done to be kind? Call in and tell them. And the little young girl called in and said that whenever they go through the grocery store line, they ask the cashier, do you eat chocolate? And if she says yes, he or she says yes, they buy them a candy bar and give them a candy bar. And the little young girl said that most of the time the cashier end up crying. I can imagine that, because sometimes, and I know you felt like that at times, who thinks of me? Who appreciates me? You know, especially when you're working in a customer service type environment and that's your job. You're supposed to be kind. You're supposed to be nice. But then you say, but who's nice to me? Who's kind to me? Who remembers me? You know, so just remember, you know, some people, and, you know, be kind. Not just today on World Kindness Day, but, you know, the people that you come in contact with every day, even at work, you know, choose somebody who don't even deserve your kindness. I mean, like, that's the best thing right there. When you are kind to someone who does not even deserve your kindness. Can you imagine that? Blowing somebody away with your kindness, and you know, and better yet, they even know that they don't deserve your kindness. So I just thank you all for your kindness here. You all are so, so wonderful and encouraging and kind to me. I know you all often say that I encourage you, and I appreciate that, but I appreciate you being here. I mean, some of you have been here for years and years and years. Yes, I appreciate my new people, but some of you have been riding with me for years, like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I think I've been here 10 years, almost 11, and some of you even 11 years. You know, and wherever you came into The Blessed Place, I want you to know that I appreciate you, appreciate your kindness, appreciate your kind words, your thoughtfulness, you putting your time, energy into even watching my videos. And I know a lot of times we watch videos, and while we're doing other things, you can't always leave a comment, because sometimes I'm watching your videos while I'm washing dishes, washing clothes, riding, you know, on a treadmill. So sometimes you can't always leave a comment. So I realize that more of you are watching than leaving comments, and that's okay. I do ask that every now and then when you have a chance, just stop by and just say something, so I'll know you're one of my blessed ones, and I'll know that you're watching. Because people have sent me messages and said, D, I've been watching your videos for 5 years, but I've never left a message. But they inbox me like privately and say, I just want you to know how you changed my life and how you helped me, how you this and that. And y'all I just start crying. I'm like, I never even heard of you before. I've never even seen a comment. But and sometimes they'll mention something. They like, I've been watching you ever since you were at the house in Deltona, or I've been watching you ever since before you retired from the sheriff's office, or I've been watching you ever since the time you did this or that. And I'm like, wow, you really have been watching, huh? So I appreciate that. And so I just want to shout out, oh my goodness, there's so many of you to shout out, so I'm just going to try to do a few each video. But I just want to shout out Leah. Leah, I love you, girl. I appreciate all your kindness and your comments. I want to shout out Pete. Pete said that he air quotes also, air quote prophets. When I talk about those prophets, and Pete said he air quote prophets also. Bobby, I want to shout you out. Bobby, who's Nirvana. Nirvana, Bobby, you've been riding with me for a while, and you said that you needed my encouragement that time I put out that video because you're finding out that you're getting laid off, and at 43, you got to start all over. Girl, I just want to encourage you. I want to encourage you and uplift you and let you know that you, whatever it is that you think you're losing now, you can get back even more so. You can get back, whether it's in the same pay or whether it's just a better environment or whether it's something that will release your time, whatever it is, your situation can be better than what it was. Just try not to stress too much. You might stress a little bit, you might shed a tear or whatever, but just don't stay in it. Just don't stay in that place of discouragement. Don't just stay in that place of anxiety or fear. Sometimes anxiety can come over us. As I get older, I never, ever had anxiety until I think around November, December of 2017. And every now and then, a little anxiety washes over me. And I think it's because of age and so many people dying. And I start thinking about, oh, Lord, I'm 52, Lord. And half my life is gone. So every now and then, a little anxiety will kind of wash over me. Oh, Lord, what time is it, y'all? Oh, okay. I got a few more minutes. But then I don't stay in that place. I remind myself that, you know, this is life. You know, this is the way life goes. You know, we live and eventually we have to die, but it's all about the legacy that we leave while we're here. A legacy of love, a legacy of encouragement, a legacy of kindness. What are we imparting into people while we're here so that that legacy can live on? See, because this flesh and blood won't live on, but love and encouragement and kindness and uplifting people and those things can live on. So, Bobby, I just want to encourage you that whatever it is you're losing right now, whatever you think you're losing right now, you know, you may feel some kind of way about it, but just don't live in that place. Just know that, girl, 42 or 43, you still young. You are still young. So there's still so many amazing things that in store for you. And it's just all about you being able to see those amazing things and go out and get those amazing things. Because if we stay home, down, and depressed, we don't know about those amazing things that are yet before us. So whatever it is that was taken from you, God can replenish it. Give you beauty for ashes, give you far more than what you lost or what you even think that you have lost. So that's my encouragement to you, Bobby, but that fits anybody who's lost. If you lost a home, God can restore you to get another home. If you lost a vehicle, God can restore you to get. I got a nephew, y'all, he done had 4 repossessions. We laugh at him. He done had 4 repossessions and he got another car. Honey, those car lot people will give you another car. Don't stress over a repossession. Don't stress over it. They will give you another car. Almost give it to you. Just bring a little down tape, baby. They don't care nothing about your repossession. Another home, you get a house repossessed, a couple of years, you can get another one. It's like whatever it is that you have lost, you know, even loss of family members. No, they can't be replaced. But God can give you just beautiful ashes. He can just give you those memories of them. He can give you that feeling that they're still there, ever present. I miss my daddy. Every now and then, I, you know, shed a tear. And then I start smiling, thinking about the memories of him. And what the legacy he left behind, legacy of humor, of love, of caring for people. So I just wanted, it's time for me to get into work, but hopefully that encouraged someone. You know, there are few messages in there. Number one, I appreciate you all, my blessed ones. Number two, thank you for encouraging me, as I encourage you. And drop me a message anytime. Don't think that you're bothering me. Drop me an inbox message. The best way to send me a message is on my email, ask so blessed one at yahoo.com. AskSoSoBlessOne@yahoo.com. But even if you don't use that one, you can inbox me here on YouTube, or you can follow me on Facebook also. Or you can use Messenger. Yeah, Messenger part of Facebook. Anyways, get at me if you want to. If you ever need more encouragement that I can offer here on this video. Okay, you guys. Thank you again. Love you. Appreciate you. And all my veterans, all my veteran blessed ones who watch, I appreciate you for all that you have given and given up and sacrificed for us. And not just you, but your family. All right. Love y'all. Y'all be blessed. Y'all have a wonderful, blessed week.